questions to be answered during the course of this mega event tonight here on Nitro. It's going to be Booker T and Psychosis for the WCW TV belt. Of course, as you know, fans, a 10-minute time limit here on WCW Monday Nitro for the TV belt. Chris Benoit knows it all too well. And this is the case where you're the television champ. You can, Booker T, although it's not this type of athlete, you can put it in the deep freeze and get the time limit to work in your favor if you're the champ. But Booker T is the type of athlete, much like all athletes, will put it behind him. He will focus on winning a matchup.
Let me explain something to you, pal.
Thank you, go ahead.
When you're a champion, you make more money, right? So for him to take advantage of the time limit was something they made. That's the rules of WCW, right? The time limit.
I understand.
Booker didn't make that rule.
No,
he should take advantage of it. And make as much money as he can. And use the time limit. Use your opponent. Use whatever you can and continue to win. That's all it's about.
And keep in mind that this fighting champion, Booker T, he didn't have that advantage last night. It was no time limit against Benoit. Quick cover here.
Would you allow me, Mr. Danae, to respond to Turnbuckle Breath here?
Go right ahead.
Okay, here's what I say to that. If it gets down to the time limit, if it gets down to where there's 2 minutes or 1 minute left to go, yeah, he'll try to do it. He'll try to put in the deep freeze. He'll try to stretch it out and maybe hold on to the belt. But he'll come into the match not trying to slow things down from the beginning. He'll come in to win from the get-go to try to pin the man.
Well, that's the way Booker T is. I'm just saying.
Cover one,
two. A smart man would take time. He would let the man make mistakes. He'd let him try to beat me. He'd take his time out of the ring. He'd go into the corner. He'd go under the ring. He'd go get a hot dog, get some cotton candy. Whatever you have to do, kill time.
And now with an arm bar straddling, putting the pressure points right on the back and on the arm of Psychosis. Psychosis certainly has the ability to become television champ. Truly one of the most successful luchadors that we've seen become a part of WCW.
Been on quite a winning streak as of late, including a victory over La Parca last night at Spring Stampede.
Spring Stampede, an event you could see. The encore presentation available beginning tomorrow night on request. Viewer choice. Oh. DirecTV with Direct Ticket and the Dish Network, of course. Make the appropriate phone call and relive some of the biggest moments in 1998 in pro wrestling.
And if you watch that Spring Stampede replay, you're going to see the controversial conclusion to the Benoit Booker T matchup. How about that special angle on that replay that we saw at the end of that match? That really told the story.
Sure did.
What I want to see is the Dallas match with Raven. They fought off stagecoaches into hay, broke down barriers, tore down sets. That was a hell of a heck of a fight.
Wagon wheel, a bull or two got involved that time. The VIP set, where our VIPs were sitting, got ransacked.
Did you see that big bull they had there?
Forget about that. As they stomp on the back, here we see now Booker T at the receiving end of kicks by Psychosis.
It would be easier to run down a list of items that they didn't use in that matchup last night.
That's exactly right. It's all part of a big night that happened in Denver in front of a sold-out crowd that you can relive or see for the first time beginning tomorrow night and all through the week on pay-per-view or direct ticket. Psychosis going for the legs here, guys.
Drop kick to that knee. You don't see that much. It's a good move, though.
Up on top, Psychosis. His primary weapon, the guillotine leg drop. But a spinning body attack caught him. One, good cover. Only got a two, though. And out of it is Booker T.
And Psychosis looks frustrated. I think that he figured that that was the move to put away Booker T and bring the world's television title to Psychosis.
Look at the paint on the face. Good work that time. Paint on the face. Booker T.
He doesn't have any teeth.
Trying to fight off the surfboard attempt by Psychosis.
Surfboard. Booker T got back up, but Psychosis one step ahead. And on that section. Knife edge champ sends the TV champ reeling back to the ropes. Here's a reversal. In. That time, I thought maybe he tried to slide through the legs, but he ended up catching the man in the knee. And I tell you, if you catch a man in the slide of the knee, Mike, any athlete will tell you that's your most vulnerable spot. That can blow a knee right out.
And Booker T just crumbled. You can see that he's in pain holding on to the knee.
And not only that, when a guy stands on your ear, that doesn't make you feel any better either.
Of course it doesn't. And of course, when you're vying for a major belt in WCW, you'll pull out all stops. And like we talked about, use every offensive weapon you can. And I wonder what is going to transpire later on tonight when you fans, along with us, millions of households around the world, each and every wrestling fan who loves this sport, who respects this sport, who have followed this sport for years, will be glued to the sets coming up later on in this third hour of Nitro when Hogan and Savage battle for not only the world title that Savage now owns, but maybe the constituency within the NWO.
Oof. No, you don't want to miss this one. You do not want to miss this one.
I think we knocked him out, guys.
Big forearm smash, and Psychosis went down in a heap.
Sure did. Here's a pickup. Side slam that time.
Take him out, Booker T. You got him.
Side salto. He may be going for what? Oh, maybe up on top for the Harlem Hangover, but he didn't go for it. He went for a knee drop out of the corner, but that enabled Psychosis to get back to his feet. And Psychosis going to the knee again, guys. A focal point here of the attack by Psychosis. The one focal point has been the knee.
We could have a new television champion. Imagine how he would be revered in Mexico as a television champion at WCW.
Oh, it'd be a huge accomplishment. And when you talk about this knee injury, this could be a career-threatening injury here, the way he's been attacking the knee.
Psychosis to the attack once again. And he pulls and he tugs and he throws it up to the side of the ring post. And that very, very hard, very heavy ring post, no give at all. One of the most dangerous parts of a wrestling ring is the ring post. Many weapons, safety rail, the turnbuckle, the side of the apron, but the ring post, the most lethal. And Psychosis continues to focus now on the leg, the ankle, and the knee, and he dives down the knee again.
And don't forget Booker T earlier, he got into it with Benoit. I mean, those two have no love lost between each other. It seemed that Booker T wanted to help him, but Benoit didn't want to have nothing to do with him. They got into it. They went one-on-one on the steps here.
Well, it's obvious that the controversy between Booker T and the Canadian crippler Chris Benoit is yet to be resolved.
I agree with that. And certainly many people would feel that within WCW, cover one, two, and of course even you could even consider now Diamond Dallas Page after he lost the US belt. Chris Benoit, one of the most talented non-champions in WCW right now.
And don't forget, I believe very shortly we're gonna hear a lot out of Diamond Dallas Page.
Oh hey, if any man can mount a comeback, it's gonna be DDP. Believe you me, he's not gonna let this one take him down. He's worked too hard, too long to get where he is. Into the ropes, nope. Other way, Booker T comes away with a side slam. He really rocked him that time, guys.
He may have knocked his horns off.
That may have been the lightest thing that happened to him.
Oh, I wouldn't like that.
Into the ropes, ducking low, and
good night, tag his toe.
Wow, you're not kidding. Combine that with the big forearm shot, and I mean Booker T has kicked in some offense here, sending Psychosis up, and he pancaked him down. Spin dance up. Here he comes. Watch out. Harlem sidekick. Knocked him for a loop.
That knee looks pretty good now, doesn't it?
You're not kidding.
What resiliency.
It don't.
Boy, resiliency is the operative word here, Mike, today.
He's up on top.
Waiting. Missile dropkick. Booker T with a cover.
Yes,
and Booker T is still the television champ.
Done.
Tell you what, guys, he battled through that. That was a great, great defense of a TV belt here on WCW Monday Nitro.
Incredible impact, that dropkick.